Hi folks, we're back again. We're going to be doing a homemade versus shop bought again. This time, one of my favourites is a Cornish pasty, folks. Now we all love a pasty, I'm sure you do. Cornish pasties are the benchmark in pasty making, I think, when you buy one from the shop. And Ginsters seem to be the benchmark, yeah, don't they? But we're going to try and compete with them by doing our own and seeing if we can make something which compares with this one. Right, so we've just gone out and got a Ginsters Cornish pasty here, 227 grams. It says British minced beef with potato, onion and swede, distinctly seasoned with pepper wrapped in light puff pastry, vegetable oil, palm oil and rapeseed and sunflower oil, but three different types of oil, baby, and the natural fats of the meat as well. There you go.
I just see there, look. No artificial preservatives, colours or flavours.
What's that supposed to mean then?
What's all that in there then?
I know, I can't work it out. Who knows? It's a bit misleading when you read packets, baby. And I don't know what they mean, how they get away with it. But anyway, that's that. All it does say on the front there is 100% British farmed beef. So all the beef, although there's only 12% in there, they use the word 100%. So you naturally think 100%
beef
in there. But it's 100% farmed in Britain, apparently. That's what it means. Right, well, we've got British beef here. Let's have a look closely at what we've got. So for the sake of it, we've just gone to Aldi, or Lidl, what is it, Chef? Lidl. And you can make it, I know, but this is cheap.
Do you want the puff?
Eh?
Do you want the puff pastry? Because that's puff pastry.
Okay, well, we'll have a look then.
We bought both, didn't we?
Yeah, we bought both. Seeing as this one says it's puff pastry, folks, I'll have a short crust pastry.
I like a short crust.
But because we're doing it in, they've got puff, we're going to use puff as well. And we bought these from Lidl. You can buy them in the rolls already done.
85 pence
a roll, folks. It just makes life a whole lot easier.
Puff pastry is better to buy than make. I would always rather make my own pastry, but I wouldn't make puff pastry.
Yeah, okay, fair enough. So 85 pence for the pastry. Then what have we got here?
You've got your minced beef. You've got your diced swede.
Yep.
Diced carrots. And chopped onions.
Chopped onions. So all that there, how much did this lot come to here?
This all come to, my little lot, come to £4.41.
Right, but you're going to get a whole lot more than one. How much did that cost on its own?
That was £2.20.
Really?
Yeah.
£2.20. So basically this amount is double.
This is where, when you go to the co-op, you're paying double for your mince. That, when I made some shepherd's pie the other day, that cost £1.69 a mince, and I've paid £3 in the co-op. So that's a comparison of supermarket prices there.
So get where you're saying, get your mince from your butchers?
Butchers or Lidl, because it's damn sight cheaper.
Right, yeah, because we bought this from the co-op, as I say.
£3.30 that cost.
Yeah, so not the place to get it, but we was only down the road. That's why we've gone to the co-op and paid that price. Normally, she says, we'll get it from Lidl or we'll get it from a butcher's.
Yeah.
Right, so how do we make these, baby?
We're going to cook the mince off first, and we're going to add these and let this cook for a bit to let the swede soften and the carrots soften.
Right, so we'll get our little tabletop cooker set up, and then we'll just cook these and brown these off. See you in a second. Right, so we've just got our little tabletop cookers off, folks. As you know, we like cooking on these. It saves us in using the main cooker over there, which we don't use hardly at all. Now we've got these little gas bottle fired ones, and things cook a lot quicker on here. And it's a lot cheaper than running the gas stove, believe it or not. So Sharon's just going to brown these off now. Probably find we get a lot of fluid come out of there. So we'll let that cook off. So we're just going to get the vegetables going, folks. And all she's going to do is just put a little splash of olive oil. We don't use vegetable oil in our cooking at all. So a little bit of that in there.
I just really want to make sure that the swedes gets cooked.
So she's just going to drop them into a little saucepan there. Just to start cooking the hard veg. As with all supermarket mince and meat and stuff like that, it's full of water, folks. Lots of water coming out of there. But we'll drain that off anyway. So she's just going to mix the... just let that soften off in there. It just helps when we're making the actual pasties and putting them together, just that these are nice and well cooked. Right, okay, so she's just going to add the onions now, just to soften them off a little bit now. Look at that. Give them a bit of a stir around. These little cookers, folks, really do cook pretty quick as well when you're indoors. So we're just going to drain a little bit of this liquid off, folks, and then we'll add this into that. Right, so that's just what I've drained out of the mince, folks. Okay, baby. And you're...
I don't want to add too much liquid to this because it's going in the pasties.
Yeah. So we want to keep it quite dry, folks. Yeah. That's what she's saying. Okay, and all she'll do is mix all that up together now. So we're just going to start to just season it up now, folks. All she's going to do is crumble in an OXO cube. There we go. Just a tad, folks. Can I just say something? There's no potato in there. Baby, we forgot the potato.
Well, no, I forgot the potato, not you.
So we're just quickly peeling the potato here, folks. Again, it hasn't got to be cooked. It'll be diced very, very small, and then we'll also put that in as well.
What am I like, people?
Fancy forgetting the potato, baby.
I'm just thinking we're going to get quite a few pasties here.
Yeah, happy days. And this is how you actually dice your swede, isn't it?
Yeah.
Literally, just cut it small, folks. Little small blocks. And you'll probably find that the potato will actually disintegrate into the sauce. So there you go, folks. We've now corrected our little error. We're only human. So we'll just mix all that round, put the lid on, we'll season it up. And all we're gonna do is put some ground black pepper in there. Put quite a bit in, baby. We like quite a bit, don't we? Ginsters ones are well known for having their peppery flavour in there, as you see. Nice bit of salt in it, folks, because you need to taste the salt. And we're also going to add in some of our superb Maggi seasoning as well, folks. This really does bring out the savoury flavour of any minced products. Let's just show you afterwards what it is. Some people could put Worcester sauce in, couldn't they? This is Maggi seasoning. We use it quite a lot when we're savouring up our mince and stuff like that. There we go. So we'll let that cook down, folks. So we'll come back to you when that's all nicely done, and then we'll prepare our pastry. Happy days. Right, so while that's cooking away, folks, what we thought we'd do, we was going to do the puff pastry like what we said, but Sharon had a good idea. And what was that idea, baby?
Well, we've got so much filling, we'll do puff pastry and shortcrust pastry.
Yeah, so we'll see what both look like, because I love a bit of puff pastry. I love a bit of, what's it called? Shortcrust. So this is the pastry as it comes out the bag. So this one's the puff pastry, right? Now, you've got to be careful with this stuff, haven't you? Because it's dry, you don't want it to dry out, do you?
Oh my God, we're not going to get a lot, are we? My size plate for the filling.
Is that one sheet, is it?
That's one sheet, that's it.
Okay, okay, well, fair enough.
We're getting one.
Go on then, get your plate. What are you going to do then?
Just literally cut round the plate.
Is that going to be too big now?
No, but the time you carved it.
That's a bloody big plate you got there. I'm thinking more of that one. Looking at that, you'll get two out of that, won't you? So we just changed the size of the plate, folks, just to suit. So she's just going to cut round there. Round, just round the pastry, round the plate, just to give it our shape. There you go. You could do two. There we go.
They've even crimped it.
I know the edge of the plate's got a crimp on it, hasn't it? And don't forget, Shell, we can always roll that into a ball and then make a third one if we wanted to. Again, we're just doing this for convenience, folks. You could make your own pastry, as Sharon says. It's quite easy. But this is a lot messy. Right, so she's just taking the out bit away. And we'll keep that because we'll make something else with that. Probably another smaller one off camera.
Leave that.
So that's the puff one. Do you want to put a P in the middle so we know that's a puff pastry? But I think we'll know, won't we?
Just stick it a bit wrapper.
Yeah, that's it. So that's that one's. That's the puff pastry, folks. This is the short crust pastry, which should probably look exactly the same, Shell, shouldn't it?
Yeah.
Pastry looks like pastry, doesn't it? I thought there was a couple of sheets in there. That looks a bit more yellowy, doesn't it, that stuff?
That's what I make my own.
Yeah. There you go. Oh, be careful, it's ripping there. Again, probably because it's more shorter, isn't it, at this show?
No, because this one's been out, that one's been out longer. This is still cold.
So it was a bit sticky, that one, folks. So she's just put it all in a blinking lump and started rolling it out ourselves. Just makes life a little bit easier, but we did get one out of that. This is the short crust pastry, don't forget. So it just don't take long, really, to roll out a bit of pastry. Look, it was all cracking up, so.
Trying to get the same thickness on it, that'd be about it.
Yeah, that's not worse. That looks good, baby. Get your plate. There we go. So much easier, isn't it? There you go. So that's our two short crust pastries.
Third.
Yeah, go on, try and go for a third, baby. I say, you might as well use it, folks, because it's all just extra pastry. Perfect, look at that. So you're getting three good pastry. That's probably about 7 inch round them. They're about the size of an old 45 single, weren't they, Sharon?
Yes.
So out of an 85 pence roll of pre-made pastry, you're getting three massive pasties made. There you go. And you want to do that other one there as well? That last one there?
Yeah.
Again, this one is the puff pastry, folks. That was the remainder of the puff pastry. Again, just keep turning the pastry around 90 degrees, and you'll find it. Otherwise, you'll just end up with a long sausage if you don't keep turning it around. You're there now, baby. Look at that. Perfect. How about that? Now with that shell,
I'm going to combine them and see what we can get out of the
tube. Oh no, I was going to say, take one out.
Yeah.
Right, in the bottom of our cupboard there, we've got that little pie tray, the little pie dish. You know what we were going to make our pie mash things out of? Again, this is on the fly now, folks. Look, we've got these little pie dishes, look.
Can I grease
that? Yeah, grease it with butter, hold on. This is live editing, folks. This weren't planned at all. This is just with a little bit of spare pastry, look. We're just going to dab that round, make sure you put plenty on. You don't want it to stick. Well, butter your pie dish, folks, and round the edge. Don't forget the edge.
See, when I do this, I don't know if this is an old thing.
I didn't understand a word of that.
What I do?
What's this?
Flour it afterwards as well.
Right, so you buttered it first.
Yeah, and the flour.
And then put flour in there. I didn't know that. I've never seen that done before. Right, so we have the on the bottom we have the short crust.
Is it?
Yep. On the bottom we have the short crust. So roll it out there, and on the top's the flaky pastry. That's just like they do. See, when you're making pie mash, folks. This is how they do it. They have two types of pastry, don't they? I think the one on the bottom's a short crust and the one on the top's a flaky. She'll feed that in there, she'll press it into the corners, and then she'll trim it off round with the knife once it's all flattened off. This is what you call cook's perks, folks. Here we go, look at this, look, cook's perks. A little extra for the cook, because the cook might not have got fed, baby. There we go.
I should think the cook's sick of food than the
boss. Well, cooks always have a little taste of everything, don't they? So that's that one, and we'll keep the other bit. This will be for the lid, folks.
Yeah.
This is going to be the puff pastry. We'll just roll that out, and then we'll put that to the side as well. This is bonus content. This is an Easter, what do you call an Easter egg, Sharon? That'll be fine, yeah, that's fine. Right, okay, I think we're ready for our filling. But filling, first of all, has got to cool down. Is that right, Sharon?
Not really.
No? Right, okay then.
Got to get an egg to paint your pastry with.
Right, so we'll get the filling out.
Let's turn that off and then I'll clean and get an egg.
Let's have a little look at that, baby. Oh, look at that, look at that, look. Lovely. You want to smell that, folks. I wish we had smelly vision here. That's fantastic. Right, we're back, folks, and we've let the mixture cool down in the fridge. We've had it sitting in there for about 20 minutes, so it's nice and, well, it's still warm, but it's a lot cooler than what it was. So, right, we're going to assemble our pasties now. Sharon's going to do that, so let's get in close and have a real good look at it. So we're just going to plonk it in the middle.
You don't want to go too mad.
And we're just getting the old egg wash around the outside. Right, so she spooned the quantity into our pastry. And again, it's all guesswork, folks. There's no measurements here. You could have done these flat, but we're doing it with a peak where the pasty's actually standing up. So you can choose whatever way you want to do them. Right, well, I'll tell you what. You stand with the camera, baby, and let me have a go. Right, well, I'm not too happy with the shape of that one, but there we go. We'll have a look, we'll see how it goes. Right, let's put them down there like that. Let's get a nice bit of meat to go into the middle. Again, I'm no expert, folks, as I've told you before. We're just making it up as we go along. And we'll see how it goes. Right, so a bit of egg wash around the side. Again, they may ooze out, they may not, I don't know. Just bring it up to the middle. And then we've got to really press these together and crimp. Really press them together. You don't want to mess about them too much because they'll unfold. I think you fold them back on themselves. There we go. How's that looking? How have I done there? Is that all right? Do you like that?
Yeah, I love it.
So I'm going to do the last one then.
Yeah, my hands are right, I'm hot.
There we go. So straight away, just up into the middle, my first initial crimp, and then I'm coming down and folding back on it. Like that. There we go. And same with this one. Close and fold back and then leave it alone. Close and fold back and leave it alone. And then that last bit can just be pinched in. Well, there you go. That's just me, folks. She was getting all hot and bothered, and I've had to jump in. Let's do the rest and we'll show you them when they've all been prepared. So here they are, folks. They may not be the prettiest, but hopefully they'll be the tastiest. We've got how many? 3, 6 and 1 pie for how much?
£5.26.
And this thing from Ginsters, that cost us?
£2.20.
So we're going to...
Over double.
So we're going to put these in the oven now, see how they turn out.
You've not brushed them, have you?
No, I haven't brushed them once yet. So these are the short crust, and we've also done puff pastry as well. And we've also managed to get a pie out of it as well. So there we go. She's just putting a little bit of a dusting on there, folks. Of paste, what's it called? Egg wash?
Yeah.
That just helps it brown off as well. So they may leak out, folks. We're not experts at the end of the day, so we're just playing it by ear. So we'll cook these up now, and then we'll put the Ginsters in the air fryer towards the end of the cooking on this one. So we'll see you in a minute. Right, here we go, folks. 20 minutes later, is it?
Yeah, about that 20.
20 minutes later, we've heated that up in the air fryer. That's red hot. That's the Ginsters one, or Ginsters. And we've now, well, we had a couple of openings, bit of bursting open. We're not expert pastry people, obviously. These ones are made on machine, so it's not about presentation. It's about quality and quantity in this case. So first of all, let's have a closer look at them. So there's our Ginsters one, which is lovely and shaped as it should be, but obviously we haven't crimped as well as they have done. Theirs is made with puff pastry. And right directly behind are our puff pastry ones. We've got 3 full-size ones there, and I can see already that one that burst open. There's a whole lot more filling in them, and we actually made an extra pie as well. So we're going to use the open one, folks, just to get that off. This is the puff pastry, as I said to you. So we just put that on the plate. And we also made an extra 3 made with short crust pastry. And again, we was getting better. Look at these, look, they're getting a lot better with the crimping, folks. So it's just that we ain't had the practice sort of thing. So there they are. So Ginsters versus puff pastry homemade versus short crust pastry homemade. And looking at these, if we bought 2 of these, Sharon, is that correct? 2 of them.
It's £4.40.
Right, and how much did it cost us to make all of these?
All of these was £5.26.
So look at the difference in price, folks, that you're getting when you make them yourself. And don't forget, I'm expecting the filling in this to be a lot more tastier than the Ginsters. So without further ado...
I'm
going to
move these.
Yeah, she's had to put them in the oven, folks, because of the dogs. So let's have a little go of these then. We'll cut open the Ginsters first of all. And just have a little look inside. I'll try not to crush it too much. And we'll see what we're like with filling in this one. So let's tip that open that way. We'll cut open this one. This is the puff pastry homemade. Let's just open that up as well. And this is the short crust pastry homemade as well. Again, I'm trying not to crush them, folks. And let's have a closer look at the inside of these, folks. Just hold that. With the Ginsters one, you can see it's a lot lighter, the filling. The mince is obviously a lot more finer in that one. And you can see the slices of potato in there. It looks all right.
You know, when I'm looking at that, I see sage and onion stuffing.
But that looks all right. Yeah, that's nice. The proof is in the flavour. We've done a test turn on one of these before. And they do taste a bit peppery, baby, don't they?
Yeah.
And this is our homemade flaky pastry. Again, there's a lot more filling in these, you can see it.
Yeah, it's juicy, isn't it?
And it looks a lot more juicier than the other one, yeah. That one looks a lot more drier. And the one that looks even more juicier, you can see there is the short crust pastry one. That's probably going to be my favourite. A lot more filling, a lot more desirable in my eyes. So first of all, let's just try a bit of the Ginsters first of all. That is our benchmark. There you go, baby. Have a bite of that, see what you think. Straight away, paper.
Potato
and pepper.
No meat.
That could be a vegetarian pastry. Pastry's nice. What I have noticed is all these processed pies and stuff only have about 15% meat in them, don't they? 15 to 20% if that.
Mm.
But that's all right. It is a Ginsters pasty, and again, I didn't realise how little meat there was tasting. The first thing you get is potato, and then you get pepper. Right, let's try this one, baby. This is our home-cooked flaky pastry. Mmm. Potato, carrot, and the gravy. You can taste everything.
That's nice.
And it does help having the gravy. It keeps it lovely and moist. That was a little bit dry, that one. That is lovely. That's flaky. This is...
short crust.
Short crust. Got to be careful here, folks. This one's a lot more juicy. Put a bit more juicy in this one. I love this pastry. This is the better pastry for me. Mm. Nothing wrong with the flaky. But again,
there's more flavour for short crust.
We did put pepper, quite a bit of pepper and salt in this, but no way is it
peppery,
powerful as the flavour of the pepper in the Ginsters.
Because you've got all the other flavours coming through.
You can taste all the other flavours in this one, yeah. And don't forget, once you've ate your Ginsters, if you're still hungry afterwards, you've got to spend another £2 or two, whatever.
Mm.
You've got at least three for the price of that one. I'll tell you what I want to get out as well. I want to get that pie out of the oven. We left, where is it? Because this pie was our little bonus out of just leftovers. So, look at that.
Can I move?
Right, I'll get another tray, I'll get another plate. Right, okay, folks. So this is hot. They're in metal dishes. I'm gonna turn it over.
Oh,
oh look. Oh, that's hot, folks. Let me turn it back over. Right, let's show you that while Sharon cuts it. Right, baby, just as that homemade pie, folks. Look, this was a little bonus thing. Normally pay £2 for something like this.
More than £2.
Cut it open then, just like, pry it open. Oh, look at that, look. Look at that. That is a homemade pie, folks, and that was a little bit of extra, just that the odd bit of pastry that was laying there, Sharon, wasn't it?
Mm.
I know what it's going to taste like, Sharon, but I just want to have a go. And it, look how full that is, folks, look.
He just loves pie.
Look how full it is. I do love a pie. Mmm. Mmm.
Makes you wonder when you make something and how cheap we've made this.
Yeah.
Why you buy? Because you could make a load and freeze them.
Don't forget we've got another tray about two big pasties. We picked the smallest ones out of these. But the flavour and how filled they are is the thing I want to try to get across to you. And how much more flavour? That Ginsters one, for example, that one. Yeah, sure, of course, we've all eaten them out, but...
It's filled.
All you can taste is pepper and potato. There's no meat flavouring at all, and yet these are full with meat flavouring. Mmm. I'm dropping everything, baby.
Oh, don't drop your pie, love.
Right. Well, I think it goes without saying, doesn't it? What we prefer... And even if you're going out somewhere, for example, when they're driving the car or a picnic or whatever, cook these up first, put them in a blinking cool box or whatever, and even eat them cold. Because I would imagine they'll be easier to eat cold because they'll solidify. Anyway, thanks very much, folks. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check out our other food review videos. We do them Monday, Wednesday and Friday. At 3 o'clock in the afternoon, they come out UK time. And if you want to join us on Sunday when we put out our weekly vlog, that's of our family life, what we get up to during the week, you can watch that at 8 p.m. and we'll be there live in the chat box because it's premiere and you can ask us any questions and have a little laugh and a joke with everyone else. Thanks very much, folks. I'm going to enjoy these now. We'll see you in the next video and until then, bye for now.
Bye.